In recent days, a series of videos that show Israeli soldiers assaulting Palestinians and journalists, destroying gift shops, burning food, and in some, using a phrase that some might interpret as calling for genocide have emerged. These are deeply troubling, we'll show you some, but do beware that some of this footage is graphic. Let's take a look. Now, media reports that the man is named Mustafa Al-Haruf. He's a veteran photojournalist currently working for the Turkish state-run Anadolu agency. And you can see Israeli police assaulting him. He was later taken to the hospital for cuts and injuries to his face. The incident was covered by Nir Hassan of Haaretz, who explained, "We started walking and then a police officer told us not to pass there. We tried to explain that another officer asked us to go through there, but he just started kicking us. Al-Haruf was handcuffed and threatened to be placed under arrest. Only after one of the officers noticed his physical condition was he released. Al-Haruf was transferred to the Al-Makassed Hospital, I hope I'm pronouncing that right, in East Jerusalem, where he was treated for deep cuts to his head and face." Now, the officers were suspended after this video was released. But there are other videos that show Israeli troops vandalizing stores and burning food. Let's take a look at those. Now, this is a video of a Israeli troop vandalizing a store in Jabalia, which is a city in northern Gaza. Here you see troops setting fire to food and aid. And this is in Shajaya, which is a neighborhood in Gaza. One soldier says in this video, "We turn on the light against this dark place and burn it until there is no trace of this whole place." And this video, I think many people have seen this week. There were different soldiers disrespecting, I think is probably the best word, a mosque in Jenin, which is in the occupied West Bank. The IDF hasn't disputed the authenticity of these videos. In fact, the soldiers in the last video have already been removed from operational activity. CNN also notes that many of the videos like these were posted, quote, apparently by the soldiers themselves. You know, we've seen a lot of footage from the attacks on Gaza, the bombing. We see like the death toll rising, but I think this is an interesting look, and it's certainly not unique to Israeli soldiers, like the callousness, but I do think it helps people better understand just the type of behavior that war brings out in people, no matter who participates. I'm curious what both of you think of these videos.
Yeah, I was actually gonna say the same thing. Like, you see soldiers doing terrible things in all wars, and that's because it's a war. And I'm not, don't get me wrong, I'm not justifying it. I'm gonna say very harsh things in a minute, so don't worry. But that's why you shouldn't have war. You should work towards peace. You know what Israeli soldiers did to Egyptians recently? And what the Egyptian soldiers did to Israelis? Nothing, because they did a peace deal in Camp David. And so they haven't fought at all, they haven't killed each other, they haven't done war crimes, they haven't humiliated one another. You know why? Because they have peace. Egypt was the number one enemy of Israel. And at the time, everybody said, oh no, you can't ever do a peace deal with the Egyptians. All they want to do is kill all the Jews, kill all Israel, drive Israel into the sea. And they start a war against Israel. They literally tried to drive the Jews, the Israelis, etc., into the sea, and they did a peace deal, and it totally worked. And it turns out that once you have a peace deal, they didn't want to do that anymore. So we have to end the occupation. We have to do a two-state solution. Going in there and humiliating the people inside of Palestine, let alone killing 18,000-19,000 of them now, is never going to get to Israel to its ultimate goal. What was the point of Israel? A safe haven for Jews across the world who were oppressed. Well, as long as you keep doing this, the Palestinians are gonna fight you to the end of time. Wouldn't you? I know I would. And so when are you ever gonna get the peace unless you actually try peace?
People are trying, yeah. I mean, it's one thing, there's a lot has been said, most things have been said. One thing that doesn't get said enough is like, you just have to be in the military if you're an Israeli citizen. Like, you have to. So there's a lot of people talking about Israeli soldiers, like they signed up for this on purpose. I think there's a lot of indelicate language when it like lumps all IDF soldiers together. Like, as I said on Damage Report, I know a carpenter in Sherman Oaks who was in the IDF had to go back and he was like, I couldn't get out of there fast enough. But he had to do it. He had to do it. And that's, I mean, we've grappled with that in the past, in the world, in American history. It is tough and it does horrible things to you. It does not excuse doing these, you know, the things that we've seen. And I think it is incumbent on the military apparatus to make sure that they keep the people who are part of their military from doing this stuff. And the same way we talked about Eddie Gallagher earlier, initiate whatever you need to do to make sure that these kinds of horrible things don't happen. And it's tough. I mean, we can get into all these conversations and they have been had and they're super healthy and they feel super unhealthy and they go in circles because of course they do. Because everybody who's lived in this region of the world for 4,000 years, someone has tried to kill them because of who they are. Everybody. Currently, people have it way worse than others. But the memory of what happens, like you said, with invasions of Israel, counter invasions, the whole history, people remember. And there's this language, this unspoken and quite spoken language that I'm going to be so horrible to you that you are too afraid to do anything back for the rest of time. It gets in there and it's horrible. And I wholeheartedly encourage the kind of initiatives that have happened for basically equally as long and have succeeded in some senses with Egypt and have failed in other senses, both by actions of people within either side historically. There have been radical Israelis who killed peace-seeking Israeli leadership. There have been, Hamas, you know? I just hope that when people are having these discussions, they really understand that. And I understand the instinct not to. I understand the instinct by a lot of people to watch this video and be like, but. And for people to see, to look at other things and say, but it's tough. It's the hardest thing to do, is to live there, first of all. It's much easier not to live there. And then a really hard thing to do is to really understand the totality of what's happening and understand the implications of your opinion when you say what your position are. Because like I said I was for a ceasefire a while ago. And by doing that, I said, I know to families of Israelis whose sons, daughters have been murdered or are still alive there. I'm basically saying to them, I don't care as much about you. That's what you're doing, that's what you're saying. It's a difficult decision, it's a difficult position to take. Some people are taking it, but I hope everybody's taking it knowingly.
Yeah, so I want to disagree with one thing you're saying, Brett, because being for a ceasefire doesn't mean that you don't care about the hostages. There's many other ways to get the hostages out. So there's, I hope, more productive ways. And yeah, it involves, nothing is easy, right? You're not gonna just get them for free, right? And you might have to exchange more soldiers and you might hate that, etc. But there's a better way to get them out. And I don't know if you guys heard the story today, but three Israeli hostages escaped and then the IDF shot and killed them. And then when they asked them, why'd you shoot and kill your own hostages? They said, we didn't know, they were in civilian clothes. And they said, well, we've been taught that the civilians are a threat. So if you're not even checking to see if they're Israeli or Palestinian or whoever they might be, you've been taught the wrong thing. And unfortunately, that's very telling.
Thanks for watching the Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.